Okay. First things first. Hopefully that's in frame. I guess not. How's that? All right. This is why you take the bolts out, obviously. That comes out. Now, I've already taken these out, but normally your clutch discs run in here on these little lugs. So that goes in there, then another one goes in, it rides on the inside. That's how that's what's supposed to be in there anyway. The next thing we need to do is, I've let this sit too long, it's gotten rusty. And even though I'm not going to rebush this, because I like to run them loose. And that might seem like a lot to most people, but in Model T terms, I don't think it's worth rebushing. The process of getting these bushings out is brutal. So I think I'm going to leave it alone. I might change my mind. I don't know yet. Check these rivets, make sure those are all tight. But I don't think that needs to be rebushed. But we do have to take it apart to clean it. It'd be a hell of a lot easier to clean this in the lathe than it would be to do it by hand on the outside. Then you get it'd be better in the lathe, so that's what we're gonna do. We need to put a puller in here, and we need to pull this gear off. So if you bear with me. Let me reset for another shot with the puller on it. Back in a second. Tech tip. Grab an old valve. You're going to need something for the pusher to pull on. Push on. Put that in there. I'm going to throw that bad boy up on there and give it a crank. In there. What the hell is wrong with that? Apparently my socket shrunk. What the hell? All right, hang on. That one works. So weird. The hard part's holding on to the thing. Alright. Hang on. And we try again. That's why I put the clamp on. Sometimes they come off. Hope you could see it was starting to move. That's why the rubber moved. Maybe I didn't have it tight enough. Alright, hold your ears. Come on. Come on. So close. Maybe a bigger clamp. Give me something to hang on to, too. Not going too bad, though. Hope if I had the right size socket. Oh, a socket shrunk. Bolt shrunk. What's going on around here, anyway? Hang on. Weird stuff going on in here. Yay! All right. Gear's off. And it's free. What a pain in the butt. All right, now you can see how these come apart. Maybe. Oh, nope, gotta take the keys out. Always remember to take the keys out. One. Okay. That was easy. Now, will it come apart? Well, that came off. Well, right, so what's going on here is these teeth have worn and they're now bigger than the bushing. So we either need to file these down a little bit or pound it out. And I'm going to opt for the latter, and I'm just going to pound that out and not take any more off the teeth. And we have to, well, I might. We'll see when we're done how this bushing holds up. I'm going to tap that out and then come back. It's working. Ugh. Okay, now you can see. Maybe you can see where the teeth were a little bit proud. So we're going to chuck that up in the lathe. We're going to fix this surface, and while it's in there, I don't know if you can see that or not, it's a little itty bitty ridge right there. That's where the teeth get bigger. This is worn down, and this has been rolled. These edges have been rolled over, making this wider, which is why it didn't come off. But we'll clean them up. I'm going to clean them up in the next video. That's where it 9 minutes now, and I'm probably boring the hell out of you. So we're going to chop this up into pieces. Now, you want to see the next one? Subscribe, like button, you know, notifications, all that crap. And maybe YouTube will turn my pennies back on. Wouldn't that be amazing? So, till next time.